My life changed in the sense that I started living for God and not for people anymore. You know, that affects everything you do. Like, you can see people, even though you don't know them, in the same way that God does. You can love people you don't even know. Because when you first have been loved, it's easy to love other people.
Welcome back to our YouTube channel, Noad and Sanning. My name is Gloria and this is my husband,
Paulos Abraha.
We are so thankful for all your love and all your support, all the comments and your messages. So thank you to all of you around the whole world. Today, you are going to listen to Paulo's testimony. As you guys know, if you have followed us on this YouTube channel, you know that we are Christians. And for about 5 years ago, our life changed radically. So I have told my story and this day is Paulo's day to tell you about his story. Who were you? For the people who don't know who Paulus was before 2015, can you tell us?
I grew up together with my two parents and I'm the oldest of three siblings. So from a young age, I took a big responsibility, taking care of my siblings, taking them from practice to school and back home and forth. So this gave me a good image, a good reputation. I also went to an English-speaking school that had a good reputation, and I was a good student. I didn't cause any bigger issues or problems. But as I grew up, I started getting a love for money. And this also tempted me to start stealing. I started stealing small amounts from my classmates in elementary school, and that even continued in high school. And this stealing became greater and greater, and I ended up stealing clothes from day off and day on. But even though I had this issue with the love of money, I always went to church since I was a young kid. I always went to church almost every Sunday, and I always had some kind of faith in God and Jesus. Even though I didn't have a personal faith, I still believed in God, and I had a cross around my neck. And for me, that was kind of enough. Going to church, having a cross around my neck, and being baptized as a kid, that's gonna get me into heaven. And when I grew up, I continued my studies in university and I studied computer science. And during this period of my life, I started going out a lot, started going out clubbing and partying. Every weekend we were out, and almost 1 or 2 weekdays a week. And I started feeling a greater love to alcohol as well. And for me, the clubs and the parties was my home. That's what I felt like. That's what I felt secure. That was my go-to place. That's where I was always felt like, okay, this is my home. Here I can be myself in this place. And that's how my life looked like before I started going to church. And I still had my good reputation, even though I like to party a lot, because I was not like one of the worst people on the outside. But that was because people didn't actually know that I was, for example, a thief, a small thief, stealing small stuff. So I did everything to maintain this good reputation and this good image that I have. And keep in mind that I almost never stopped going to church. No matter what I did, I always went to church because I felt there was something there for me. It was more than just a building for me. I felt at peace when I went there.
Can you tell us what changed everything in your life? Because you stopped doing all of these things that you just explained for us. What changed your life? Where was your turning point?
I would say my turning point was 1st of January 2016, and I'm sure you remember that day, New Year's Eve. And I started spending New Year's Eve with my family, and then also together with Gloria and some friends. And later on during that night, I was at my cousin's house, and it was me and him and two of his friends. And they started speaking about God, started telling us about Jesus and who he was. And it was the first time that I heard the gospel in this way. And also from men in my age, younger men in my age, whom I grew up with. And what really amazed me was that when they were speaking, something happened in my heart. A desire started to growing of getting to know the God and Jesus that they were speaking about. And they told me, Paulos, how loved I am, how much God loves me, that he wants the best for me. And I've heard this before, but that day it was like, it was the first time that I heard Jesus and what he has done for me. But what actually made me question everything, question my life, my belief, was when my cousin looked straight into my eyes that evening and he said, Paulos, if I die today, I know that I will end up in heaven. And immediately, it was like I was being flashed in the middle of the night. And I started comparing my life to my cousin's life. And comparing our lives, I was thinking, well, if he's going to heaven, then I'm definitely going to heaven. And in that same moment, I asked myself, Paulos, if you die today, will you go to heaven? I didn't have the confidence of answering yes to that question. And that made me realize that I have no idea if I'm on my way to heaven or hell. And this increased my desire of getting to know Jesus even more. So I spent the night at my cousin's house, and when I woke up, my eyes were full of tears. I could see my whole life in a movie right in front of me. And I could also see who I was depending on where I was. I had a mask when I went to church. I had one mask when I was with my guy friends. I had one mask when I was at work. One mask with relatives and families. One mask when I was out clubbing. So I realized that, whoa, nobody actually knows me to 100%. Because everyone around me had only seen small pictures of who Paulos actually was. And to be honest, in that moment, I wasn't even sure that I knew myself. But I knew that God knew who I was. I knew at the moment that God had seen me, everything. Even those things that I thought nobody had seen, I knew that God had seen me. And the same moment, being lying there in the bed in my cousin's house, I could feel the love of God. I could sense His grace and mercy and how He said how much He loved me. But at the same time, I felt like as the greatest sinner, and I just begged God for forgiveness. I begged Jesus for forgiveness. Forgive me for not being a follower of you. Forgive me for showing the wrong example of what it is of being a Christian. And my tears just keep running and running and running down my cheeks. And I could see how my cousin was about to wake up, so I started wiping away all my tears because I didn't want my cousin to see me crying. He would ask me, "Well, what's happening?" And after this day, I started going to church with my cousin and his friends and started reading the Bible. And this was the beginning of my journey with Jesus Christ.
This is a typical moment when you meet the love of God, when you realize that you have lived your whole life without Jesus. What it does to you is that you start to question your old life, and you get a longing. You long to live a life for Jesus. So I know that this is where it started for Paulos, when he saw his own cousin's life. And I'm so glad to see his change, because I have seen him from the first day, and also all of his friends and his family who knew him before and know who he is today. They have seen a change. Even though everybody might not understand what has actually happened, I have seen it on a close view. And it has been amazing seeing your change in God. And I'm so happy of the person that my husband is today. And I have seen this change on a close view. Who are you today? Can you tell us? Because now we've heard who you were before. What happened that night that changed your life and made you question your own life and gave you a desire to change your own life? Who are you today? What happened after that?
My priorities, my dreams, and my life completely changed. I had a dream of becoming as rich as possible. But now I realized richness is not material stuff. It's how you feel inside of yourself. Richness is, in my sense, the knowledge of God and growing together with Jesus. But I remember that day when I woke up at my cousin's place after like being awake for some hours. I went into my Instagram and I erased all of my image of myself with my half naked pictures. I erased pictures from the clubs and alcohol. And it wasn't that anybody told me this or I had read it in the Bible, but I just knew inside of me that this doesn't please God. Because the reason I had these pictures was that I was seeking people's confirmation. I wanted people to see me, people to give me likes, people to say how wonderful and how good looking I was. I even used to delete pictures on my social media if they didn't receive an X amount of likes. My life changed in the sense that I started living for God and not for people anymore. And that affects everything you do. Because now you can see people, you don't see trees. Like you can see people, even though you don't know them, in the same way that God does. You can love people you don't even know. Because when you first have been loved, it's easy to love other people. But if you're just craving, if you just want other people to always love you, it's gonna be hard to give out. But when you know that you are loved, that's like the position in life, then you know what? You don't have to live for people because you already have received everything you need from God. And today we live for God. I mean, everything that we have, everything that we do, it's a blessing from God. And me working with politics, that wasn't even in my dreams. I had no interest of it. But when you start following the path and dreams that God has for you, you know what? He's going to open up the right doors and the right time for you in your life. You don't have to worry about anything. And that doesn't mean that you should sit down on your couch and, okay, God, when are you going to do this? No. Keep loving God and love people and serve Him. And join a congregation, you know what? He's gonna bless you abundantly. Today, I live a life where my happiness doesn't come from my circumstances. Like, no matter how my life is, I can still feel joy, I can still find peace and love, everything I need in my relationship with Jesus. And me and my wife, we have the privilege of living this life together. I mean, God has blessed us with so much, and I'm definitely sure that this is just the beginning. We've only been together with Jesus now for 5 and 6 years, and God has done so much in our lives. But we're happy we started this channel, and then we hope that our videos can continue to encourage you and inspire you, and also help you to take the right decisions in life. Right, baby?
I agree with everything that you shared, and I hope that this video has encouraged you or inspired you. And if you know somebody who should hear this story, share our video with that person and give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and share with us your thoughts. Send us a message. So thank you for watching this video.
If God can forgive me, I'm absolutely sure that He can forgive you too, okay? He loves you no matter what you've done. And if you seek Him, you will find Him. God bless you, and we see each other soon again. Take care.